Hello, welcome to Foodie Friday. This week I'd like to focus on Friendsgiving. Friendsgiving is a way to get together with friends who couldn't make it home for Thanksgiving, or maybe some friends who maybe were in town because of the holiday. But this year it's going to look a little different because of social distancing and quarantine ruling. So there might be some travel restrictions, there might be limits as to how many people can be in a gathering. And that's okay, because Friendsgiving can take a whole new spin. And how will that happen? You'll still be able to celebrate and give thanks for your loved ones, your friendships, and so on. You just will make new traditions. And so nothing compares to seeing your friends in person, but you certainly can make a virtual Friendsgiving. So how would we do that? Well, first of all, let's look at the benefits of having a virtual Friendsgiving party. You can invite more people. Everybody doesn't have to worry about travel plans because they can come from all over the place, right? And how exactly would you do that? Well, in other times when I've had Friendsgiving, I've had to worry about cleaning my whole house. Well, guess what? You could just have one little corner of your house be clean and all your laundry baskets and your toys and everything can be everywhere else, correct? Seems like it's pretty simple. All you need is one spot, some way to connect virtually, and you can make it happen. So first, as you're making your plans, you might want to decide if you want it to be over Zoom or something called house party. And this can be something that your family decides would be important on how everybody can connect. You would want to send out some invitations. And now, invitation sending in this time period, you can do a fancy text message or an email, or heck, pick up a phone and give them a call the old-fashioned way and let them know what time you're thinking of having your virtual Friendsgiving. After you've done that, you might want to decide on what this is going to look like. Will you have a dinner? If you have a dinner, are you going to maybe set up for them to get a box or a bag, special ingredients that they can make ahead of time, or tell them that there's certain things that you want to have happen, or maybe they'll be in charge of making their favorite dish and then they can share it with you over the Friendsgiving virtually. Heck, order a pizza and just sit and hang out. Really, the most important thing in this time frame is to be able to see people's faces and have a conversation, and that can be over any kind of a food or that sort of thing. Heck, you could even go peanut style, get some
jelly beans?
Well, if you don't know what that's all about, make sure you watch the Peanuts episode where they're celebrating Thanksgiving. It really doesn't matter if you don't have the huge Thanksgiving dinner with turkey and mashed potatoes and stuffing and gravy and, oh, I'm getting hungry. Could be as simple as toast and jelly beans, like Snoopy set up. Really, all it matters is that you're getting together. And this, as I said, doing it over virtual platform as Zoom or house party is just fine. You could even do FaceTime. Whatever works for your family, you decide. So along with that, don't forget to take time to play a game. You can figure out any kind of game that you all could do together, whether it be a virtual game. But most importantly, take the time to tell a special memory, what you're thankful for. That is so important. Now, while this is happening, we are writing history, my friends. So be sure to take time to take pictures of this virtual event. So in our family, we've determined that the Friday before Thanksgiving is when we typically do a Friendsgiving. So we're gonna set up a platform of house party. Most of us have it on either our iPhone or we're able to do it on our laptop. We're gonna take the laptop and we're gonna connect it to our television screen so that our whole family, my family within my own little house, with my children and my husband, can connect with my sisters and other relatives from out of state. We'll then play some games, tell things that we're thankful for. We might even tell a few funny stories that we remembered when my kids were little, or even when I was little. So while that happens, I'm gonna make sure to take some pictures. I'll take pictures of the screen with everybody's faces on the different boxes, as you're well aware when you do a Zoom meeting or a Google Meet. This is history, so make sure you document it. Have fun with it. Remember, Friendsgiving might look a little different this year, but we're gonna play our part in keeping everyone safe and healthy. And maybe share a jelly bean or two.
That's it, my friends.
Whatever you do, food, friends, and fun. It might look a little different, but you can make it happen. Enjoy yourselves and be thankful. I love you. Bye-bye.